Yes. So, dear, I am Rakesh from Gyanvear University. I am going to teach you right now about write a program to add 2 8-bit numbers using repetitive to multiply 2 8-bit numbers using repetitive addition method in 8085 microprocessor. Well, first of all, see this MS Paint file. Okay, now what is the meaning of this repetitive addition method? Whenever anyone tell in front of us that you have to do the multiplication of two numbers, you have to perform the multiplication of two numbers, then what you will do? You just see what are the numbers are. Let's suppose the numbers are 4 and 5. Let's suppose the number are 4 and 5. It is very easy for us to multiply these kind of numbers. The 4 multiplied by 5, that will be 4 5s are 20. Okay, so you will find out the answer. Now, how to perform this in case of microprocessor? Because microprocessor do not have, there are total approximately 80 instruction in case of microprocessor. If we categorize them in different addressing modes, there are actually 5 addressing modes: immediate addressing mode, register addressing mode, direct addressing mode, indirect addressing mode, and index implicit addressing mode. Okay, among those all addressing mode, total 80 instructions are there, and none a single instruction is directly correlate with the multiplication. For the addition, there is an instruction ADD add. Okay, for the subtraction, there is an instruction SUB sub. But for the division, none a single instruction directly for DIV, for division. No, none a single instruction for multiplication. No. So how we can perform the multiplication? So there is a very simple trick by which we can do the multiplication, and that trick is repetitive addition method. Okay, for the same example, 4 multiplied by 5, I can also perform it with the help of this repetitive addition. How? Let's suppose I have two number, one is 4 and one is 5. Just take any one number. Let's suppose I take the 4 number and just add it with itself, number of times that is equal to the second number. The number of times addition of the one number with itself equal to the number of the equal to the second number. For example, what is the second number? The second number is 5. So just add the first number. What is the first number? 4. 5 times with itself. One time add with 4, 2, then 3, then 4, and then 5 times. Okay. So 5 times it will be add. But keep in your mind that first time the number should be added with the 0. Okay. Now once again I will show you. First time, what is the number? Number is 4. First time add it with 0. First time add the number with 0. Then this is first step. Then add this number with itself. Again 4. Then again 4. Then again 4. Then again 4. So how many plus sign you see in this? Plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we can say the number 4 add with itself 5 times. Or we can understand this thing in microprocessor very simply. Just to take two numbers separately from each other. One number is 4, one number is 5. Just add the any one with itself and decrease the second number each time once till it will be 0. So what I want to say? This 4 will be add with 4, this 4 will be add with 4. One time we do the addition, so just divide it by 1. Okay, then 1 again add this with 4. Okay, now 1 again divide the second number once, so it will be 3. 1 again divide the number, add the number by itself, so 4. Now once again divide it. Okay, 1 again decrement and add with 4. Now once again decremented by 1. Okay, so remember, you should start with the 0 first time. Instead of this, what we will going to choose? Instead of this, what we will going to choose here in the case of microprocessor? Because we have to perform the multiplication of 4 and 5, because we have to perform the multiplication 4 and 5, just use a number that will be equal to 0, just use a number that will be equal to 0 one time. Okay? Then add, use the second number equal to the second number. Okay. Now, add the 0 first of all, sorry, add the 0 first of all with the first number, and each time decrement the second number once. So, first time the 0 will be added with 4, because one time we do the addition. So, decrement 5 will be decrement to 4, 1. One more time add 4, one more time add 4. Now, decrement the number once, so it will be 3. One more time add 4, then the second number will be now 2. One more time add with 4, now the second number will be 1. One more time add with 4, okay, now the second time is, second number will be 0. Now there is no need to add further. Now there is no need to add further. If this procedure is 0, then just jump to the next position, and which is the position of result. Okay. So this is the clear method by which we can do the addition of two numbers. This is the clear method by which we do the addition. So what this is known as repetitive addition, because once we start the procedure, again and again we do the same procedure till it will be 0. Whenever the decrement register value will be 0, we just quit the process and jump to the result process. Now one more example I am going to show you, so you will understand, then we will come on the programming. Let's suppose I have to multiply two number, that is 3 multiplied by 7, for example. I have to multiply two number, that will be 3 multiplied by 7. I know the result should be 21, but instead of this direct multiplication, I have to follow the repetitive addition method. So, what is the repetitive addition method? Just first of all use a value 0 in any register, and the next register will hold the second data value, and second data value is 7. Anyone, you can use here 3 also, then 7 will be added 3 times, otherwise you use 7 here and 3 will be added 7 times. Okay. Now each time use add this 0 with, each time add 3. So one time this 0 will be added with 3, because one time we do the addition, so just decrease now. Each time we have to decrement 1. Okay. Now one more time add this 3 with the first result, then decrement this 6 to 5, because one more time we do the addition. One more time add 3 with this, then one time decrement, so 5 will be decrement to 4. One more time do the addition, then one more time it will be decremented. One more time do the addition till the decrement register value is not 0, till that time decremented. Now it is 2. One more time add this, then decrement this, because it is not 0 now. Now one more time add this 3, now again decrement it. But now see, now this is 0. So don't go to the previous step, now go to the next step of result. Okay. So what will be your result? See, this will be your result, the addition of these all number. So 0 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 and plus 3. 7 times the 3 will be added with itself. So the result definitely will be 21. So this is known as the repetitive addition method by which we can perform the addition. But you should keep in your mind that the starting addition should be start, the starting bit should be start from the 0. Okay, the first number which I will use in repetitive addition method should be add with 0 itself. Okay, now how to do the programming of this? First of all, we should tag these two value in any register. First of all, we should tag these two value in any register. Okay, and one number. Let's suppose we are going to do the multiplication of 4 and 5. It means first number is 4 and second number is 5, and the third register which I have to use is should have the value of 0. Should have the value of 0. Okay, now how to do this addition? So let's suppose 0 will be my accumulator, then MBI equal is 0 value in accumulator, because in hexadecimal we represent it by 00. H is for hexadecimal, A is for accumulator. So the meaning of this instruction is load the accumulator with 0, because I require a 0. So then accumulator will be 0. Okay, now what will be the second value? The second and third step should be the data values which we are going to multiply. Because in multiplication we at least use two data bytes. So one is 4, one is 5, for example, or we can say one is 3, one is 7. So it means two numbers we should require to multiply them. Okay, so let the one register is in one data is in register B. Okay, you use any data. Let's suppose I have to multiply 4 with 5, then the first value should be 04H. Why I write down 04? Because I have to write down in hexadecimal only. Okay, then the second data, use the second data in any other register. Let I use the register C here. So MBI C comma, what is the second number? Second number is 5. So I have to write down in 05H. Now what is the meaning of these three instructions? The first requirement to perform by repetitive addition method, to perform the multiplication, I require a 0. I just encircle it with red color, kindly look on it. I must require a 0 first of all. So to use the 0, I use the 0 in accumulator. So MBI A comma 00. Now in I have to use these two values for which we are going to do the multiplication. So first number is 3 and second number is 7, or here in this case first number is 4, second number is 5. So B and C, I choose any register. Either you can choose H register, L register, you can choose D register, either L register, right? Any register, right? So here I choose B register and C register, in which I will load this. So let for the example of 4 multiply by 5, I use the first data byte, that is 4. In hexadecimal we can say 04H will be loaded into B register, and the data byte 05. It means 5 in decimal will be loaded in C register. So the meaning of these two lines will be B is equal to, when you write down MBI B comma 404H, it means B is equal to 4. And when you write down MBI C comma 05, it means C is equal to 5. Okay. Now what you want to do? You want to do first the addition of 0 with the first data. 0 with the first, you can choose anyone as a first. So among these 4 and 5, let's suppose 4 is my first number and 5 is my second number. So I have to add this second number with the first number. There is a simple instruction. Add and just write down the name of the register B. What is the meaning of this instruction? Add B. The meaning of this instruction, add register, actually the name of the instruction is, actually the statement for the this mnemonics is add register. It means add the content of accumulator with the content of this register which you mention after the ADD statement. What is the actual instruction? The actual instruction is add and register, any name of register. You can use add D, you can use add H, you can use add B, you can use add C, anyone, okay? You can use add E, okay? You can use add L, anyone, okay? So among this, what is the meaning of this? The meaning of this instruction add register is, I am going to write down in blue color, kindly look on it. The meaning of this instruction add register is add the content of accumulator. Here the meaning of A is accumulator. I just write down with the total accumulator with the content of this register which you mention after ADD. with the content of this register. Content means the data, okay, content means the data inside that register, okay, and the result will be loaded in, and the result will move into, the result will be move into accumulator itself, the result will be load into accumulator itself. Accumulator means A, accumulator means A, and register means any register you just write down. So here, by comparing this with this instruction add B, here I mentioned add B. So what is the meaning of this add B? The meaning of this add B means the content of register A will be add with the content of register A, means accumulator, with the content of register B, and the result will be stored in register A. Register E. Here the equal to means the result movement. Here the equal to means the result movement. So I just write down this. Okay. Okay. So you will easily understand. DSULT. Okay. So now what will happen? Add B means the content of A was 0. Now see what is the content of A. A was 0. Okay. Now what is the content of B? The content of B is 4. Okay. So 1 times 0 will be add with 4, then the result will be move into A. Now the content of accumulator will be 4. Now the content of accumulator will be 4. One time we do the addition. So what I have to do, because one time I do the addition, I have to decrement the second data. So where is the second data? The second data is in 5. The second data is 5, which is in B. The second data is 5, which is in B, which is in C. So I have to decrement it once, one time I have to decrement. So the instruction for decrement the content of any register by 1 is DCR. Then write down the name of the register. So the name of the register is C. So decrement the register C. Decrement the register C by 1. The meaning of this instruction is decrement the register C by 1. Okay. And at what time I have to decrement it continuously? Till it will be 0. Jab tak 0 na ho, till it will be 0, I have to decrement again and again after each addition. After each repetitive addition, I have to decrement this register C once till it will be 0. So I have to write instruction for this command is JNZ. The meaning of this instruction is what you write down just above this JNZ, DCRC. Decrement the register C by 1. Decrement the register C by 1. Now the meaning of this instruction JNZ is jump if not 0, jump if not 0. So decrement the register C by 1, and if it is not 0, jump at this location. What is the location? You can choose any location. It means you can choose any address. You can choose any address. I write down the name as location. Actually the location is any address. Let's suppose the address is 8015, okay, jump not 0 is 8015, okay, any location. So we will see during the time of program location. And what should be the what should be this location? This location is the location of add B only. This location will be the location of add B only, okay. So if it is not 0, if after the decrement, if it will be not 0, then just type, just go again for the addition procedure, okay, till it will not be equal to 0. What is the meaning of this jump not 0 location? Just above you write down decrement the content of C by 1. So C was 5, now I decrement after this addition, now 5 will be 4, now C will be 4. And if it is not 0, because it is 4, now it is not 0, it is 4 actually. So again go to location. So when it will again go to location, it will add the content of register B with the content of A, and then the result will move into A. Again decrement C by 1, and if it is not 0, again move, and the procedure will be same. Now after this, what will happen? I will again, we will recheck the program after I will explain this total. Kindly hear me out. Okay. Now after this, if it will be 0, then what will be there? Definitely my result will be in accumulator. So what I have to do, I have to store that result at any particular memory location so that we will check the result. So the result, let I store the content of the accumulator by ST instruction at any memory location. Let my memory location is 9000. Then definitely when I will check the 9000 memory location, my result will be 100%. the result of the multiplication of 4 multiplied by 5, that will be 20. But when I will do the programming in 8085 microprocessor, definitely this 20 will be in the format of hexadecimal, because microprocessor only take the value in hexadecimal format and only generate the result in the hexadecimal format. Okay, so at last HLT will be there and now program is end. So this will be a complete program for my today object. Now I understand. Okay, first of all I just remove the right hand side example. Okay, now I am going to show you the programming. First of all, here it will be. Now we hear it. Now see, so where is the program? The program are this one. The program is this one. So this is my program of today, okay, object. Now I am going to explain you step by step once again till our result comes. So see, I start my program because I have to perform a multiplication. Okay, so I have to perform the multiplication. My first number is 4 and my second number is 5. I have to multiply them. Definitely I know the 4 multiplied by 5 result will be 20. Now I do start the program. The first instruction is MVI A, 00. It means the meaning of this instruction is accumulator is equal to 0. Okay. My second instruction is MVI B, 04. It means B will load the value 4. Okay. My third instruction is MVI C, 05. It means C register value will be 5. Okay. Now the next instruction is add B. The meaning of this instruction is add the content of A with the content of B. So if the content of A is 0 and the content of B is 4, just add them. So 0 plus 4, that is equal to 4. The meaning of this instruction add register, add B is add the content of B register with the content of accumulator, that is A, and the result will all automatically move into A. So the result will be 0 plus 4, that will be 4, will move into accumulator. So now the accumulator content will be equal to 4 because 0 plus 4 is 4. Now accumulator is equal to 4. Okay. Then my next instruction is DCRC. The meaning of this instruction is decrement the register C by 1. Decrement the register C by 1. What was my content of register C? My register C content was 5. Now decrement it by 1. So now register C becomes, because it was 5, decrement it by 1 means 5 minus 1, that will be 4. Okay. My next instruction is jump not 0. Just after when we write down after DCRC, it means decrement the register C by 1. And if it is not 0, jump not 0 means if it is not 0, just jump at this location. Just jump at this location. And what we write at that location? So because it is 5 to 4, it is not 0. Because 5 was the initial content of register C, and when I write down DCRC, it decrement the content of register C by 1, so 5 now becomes 4, but it is not 0. So jump if not 0, because it is not 0, jump at this location. And what at that location? At the location LOCATION, at the location LOCATION, I just see add B once again. So what is the meaning of add B? Add the content of register B with the content of register A, and the result will be stored in A. So what is the content of register A? Register A is 4. And what is the content of register B? Register B is 4. So 4 plus 4, that will be 8. 4 plus 4, that will be 8, and it automatically store in register A. Okay. Then after add B, DCRC, one more time decrement the register C. Now again, if it is not 0, if it is not 0, because register C is from 4 to 3, it is not 0. So if it is not 0, again go to LOCATION, again go to location, and at the location what I have to do, add B. Again content of register A will be add from the content of register B, and the result will automatically be loaded into register A. A means accumulator. Okay, so now A plus 8 plus 4, so the content 8 plus 4 will be 12 definitely, and it will automatically will load into accumulator. So 12 will be the result after this addition. So DCRC, again decrement the register C by 1. So now previously it was 3, now it will becomes 2. Now it will becomes 2. It is not 0 because jump not 0. If it is not 0, because register C decrement from 3 to 2 but not 0. So again go to add B, and what is the meaning of add B? Directly move into accumulator, will automatically move into accumulator. So now 16 will be the content of register A. Now 16 will be the content of register B. Okay. Again DCRC, decrement the content of register C by 1. So 2 will be 1 now. Okay. Because it is not 0, again jump not 0. If it is not 0, because it is 1, it is not 0. Again go to location, and where what we have to do the location, the same thing. The content of B will be add with the content of A, and the result will be stored automatically in A. So A content is 16 and B content is 4. So 4 plus 16, that will definitely be 20, will automatically in register A. So now the content of A is 20. Now again decrement the register C by 1. So now it becomes 0. Now it becomes 0. So jump if not 0. If not 0, then only jump. But here, because the content of C is 0, we do not follow this instruction jump not 0. We just move in the next content of A. A means accumulator. We store the content of accumulator to this address. And what is the name of that? What is the address? Address is 9000. So store the content of accumulator at 9000. So what is the content of accumulator? Definitely at till last step, the content of accumulator is 20, will now move into 9000, and then the program ending. It means where is my result? My result is at 9000 memory location, and definitely it will be 20. But as I know, in case of microprocessor, only the hexadecimal value will be there to upload inside the microprocessor, and whenever microprocessor will generate the result, definitely the result will comes in the format of hexadecimal. So when we will check the result, this 20 will be comes in the format of hexadecimal. So first I have to know that what will be my result. To convert this 20 into hexadecimal, I must divide it by 16. So how many times it will be divided? It will be divided only one time. So what will be the remaining? 16, 1 just 16. What will be remaining? Definitely 4. So what will be the hexadecimal? So when I will check the 9000 memory location in software, I will find out 14. It means automatically my result is 20, because 14 means in hexadecimal it is 14, but actually it is how to do this programming in microprocessor. Programming in microprocessor, first I have to, and let me begin over. So first of all, I have to load the hexadecimal value of MVI A. So what is the MVI A hexadecimal value? We just see from the hex code table. So from the hex code table, we know that MVI A means 3E. I just check it, it is in front of me. So MVI A is 3. So I just write down 3 is the hex code for MVI A. Okay. Then at the next memory location, it will automatically move at 8001. What the data I have to load on accumulator, that is 00. So MVI A comma 00 is finished, because I load the hex code of MVI A from the opcode table, that is 3. Then at the next memory location, I load the content, that is 00. Then at next memory location, MVI B, what is the hex code of MVI B? That is 06. Okay, no problem. Then at the next memory location, what is the content at the MVI B? That is 04. Okay. Then at the next memory location, what is the hex code of MVI C? So again we check for the hex code of MVI C, and that is 0E. So I write down 0E. It will automatically be there. Okay. Then the next content is 8005. Then what is the content of MVI C? That is 05. So I write down 05. Now see, 8006 is the location. what is the LOCATION? We in the program we write down for the ADD B, and ADD B wherever I use the opcode of ADD B, that is my location. So what is the location? Now remember, this LOCATION is in my program is 8006, because at the 8006 memory location I am going to write down the opcode of ADD B. And what is the opcode of ADD B? I just check in the hex opcode table and it will be ADD B. So it will be 80. It will be 80. So I have to write down 80. So ADD B opcode is written at 8006 memory location. It means 8006 is my location that was previously denoted in the program in front of you by LOCATION. Okay. So that is 8006. Now at the next memory location 8007, DCRC opcode. DCRC opcode. So what is the DCRC hex code? I first of all just check in DCRC is 0D. It is 0D. So I write down 0D. Then what is the next hex code? At the 8008, I see the after this DCRC, I have to see jump not 0, J and Z. Jump not 0. So what is that jump not 0? So I just check jump not 0 label is C2. The hex code is C2. Now see very carefully. C2. So for the jump not 0, I write down C2. Now at the next memory location, I have to write down the address because it is a location, it is a address. So what is the LOCATION? And I previously found that location is that address where I write down ADD B hex code. And ADD B hex code 80 is written down at 8006. It means location is 8006. So after the jump not 0 hex code C2, I have to write down 8006. So how we can write down 8006? First the last 06, first the LSB will be come, then at next memory location, that will be after the 9, it will automatically be 8000A. Now 80 will be there. So by 800A and 8009, my location 8006 will be there. Okay, now at the next memory location, what I have to write down? STA, what is the hex code of STA? The hex code for the STA is 32. Okay, now at the next memory location 8000C, I have to write down 9000 there. So how to write down 9000? First write down the LSB, then write down the MSB, then write down the MSB. And what is the MSB? MSB is 90. And then at last, what is their HLT? HLT hex code is 76. Okay. So when I will check after this all, the result at 9000, definitely it will be 14 in hexadecimal. That is actually 20. So first, my programming steps and from the opcode table, my initial steps are complete. Now I am going to teach you how to perform this practical in 8085 simulator, where 5, 6, 7, then 8, 9, A, B, then C, D, E, F, and so on. The topmost button from the right hand side is reset, then bottommost is go, then execute is at the right hand side from the second side from the top, from the right hand side, that will be starting memory. And I have already been taught in the previous lab also about the buttons of that. So first of all, I just save this file and then I am going to teach you. Now see on this, I am going to show you the simulator. Okay. Kindly wait. You just take this image. One more time I am showing you this, and you just take this image. You just tag this image of this MS Paint file, so that whenever I will upload the opcode, you will not confuse. From 8000 to 8000E, just remember in your mind, just remind in your mind. Okay, just take a pic or anything, so you will understand that what I will have to do in 8085 simulator. Okay, now I am showing you on 8085 simulator. So this is my 8085 simulator. Wait, 80. Okay, so this is my 8085 simulator where this pin is 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, 5, 6, 7, then 8, 9, then A, B, then C, D, E, and F. Okay, then at the right hand side, from the top side, reset, new memory, next, and all those things. So, what are or which one is necessary for us? This one is the reset key. This top one is the reset. Okay, this one is next, this one is go, and this one is execute, and this one is new memory location. As I have already been taught you the front panel and even show on you MS Paint file. Okay, now see what I have to do, because my programming is at the 8000. I have from the 8000 I have to start. So first of all, click on reset, then click on new memory location, or okay, then click on 8000. So now 8000 is the starting address. Now what is the data I have to load on this 8000? Code of MBL. Okay, at the 8001 I have to load 00. So 00 itself is there. Then next, at the 8001 06 I have to load. So where is the 0? 06. At the 8002 I load the 06. At the 8003 I have to load the 04. So at the 8003 0, then 4. Then at the 8004 I have to load 0E. So 0 and then E. Then next. At the 8005 I have to load 05. So 0 and 5. Then next. 8006 I have to use 80. So 8080. Then at the next memory location I have to load the content 0D. So 0 and D. Then at the 8008 I have to load C2. So this is C and this one is 2. Then next. Then at the 8009 I have to load 06. So 06. Then next. Then at the 8000 A I have to load 80. So 80. Then next. Then at the 8000 B I have to load 32. So 32. Then next. At the 8000 C I have to load 00. So 00. Then next. At the 8000 D I have to load 90. So I have to load 90. So I use 9 and 0. Okay, 90. Then next. At the 8000 E I have to load 76. 76. So I use 7 and 676. Then one more time next. Okay, so whatever the program I have already been taught you right now few minutes ago, I just load that whole program as it is in these memory locations. Okay, once again I am going to show you so that you will keep in your mind that this was my program. So see, one more time, kindly look on that MS Paint file. So this was your program. This was your data program to multiply 28 numbers by repetitive addition method. For that, we just tag two data, that is 4 and 5, and I have to multiply them by repetitive addition method. So I created already a program, and I also checked from the opcode table what the hex code for these different instruction, and I just write down. See carefully, from the 8000 I have to load 3, then 00, then 06, then 04, then 0E, then 05, then 80, then 0D, then C2, then 06, then 80, then 32, then 00, then 90, and then 76, and then one more time next. So I do these all similarly in 8085 simulator. So I once again show you so that it will be cross-checked. Okay, so it will be cross check. Now see, this is my 8085 simulator. Okay, this is my 8085 simulator. Now I click on reset, then memory location. So at the 8000 memory location, I have to load the first data, that is 3. Yes, 3 is there, then 00, then 06, then 04, then 0E, then 05, then 80, then 0D, then C2, then 06, then 80, then 32, then 00, then 90, then 76. Now the program end, one more time, click on next. Okay. Now the loading step is completed. How to load the program in 8085 simulator? I have already been taught you in previous labs, and right now we just do it once again. Now how to execute the program? Click on reset, then click on go, then type the starting memory location. So what is the starting memory location program? That is from 8000. So I click on 8000. Then when you click on execute, if it will be E, and at the right hand side in this blank screen, if automatically the program will be written by the software, it means your program is correctly, typically the program will be coming right hand side. MVI A, comma, acknowledge it there. Okay. Now memory location, and then what is the result memory location? Because I write mention when I click 9000 and when I click on next, if my programming is correct, then definitely the result will be 20, because that will be 14. And when I click on next, see, the result is 14. So our program is corrected, and 14 means 20. So 4 multiplied by 5, with the help of repetitive addition, we find the result as 20. Okay. So now this is the result of this programming. Thank you very much.